Hello everyone, this is Gaston, admin of the healthcare engineering team. I am really glad to bring you another video under medical devices category. Today we are going to talk about electrosurgical unit. If you work as a biomedical engineer, especially as a clinical engineer in a hospital environment, or if you work as a product specialist in a company who deals with electrosurgical units, you must know the importance of the electrosurgical units in modern surgeries. In a nutshell, we can say electrosurgical unit uses a high frequency electrical current to cut tissue and control bleeding by causing coagulation. There are so many important things we should know about electrosurgical units. Our team member Sumita is explaining thoroughly about electrosurgical unit in this video. So I would like to welcome you all to watch this entire video to know more about electrical surgical unit. Before getting into the video, I would like to welcome you all to subscribe our YouTube channel Healthcare Engineering and provide your huge support by subscribe, share our channel and provide your comments and likes to encourage us. Also, please share our channel with your healthcare professionals so that we can get your encouragement to provide more and more informative videos like this in future. Thank you. Let's watch the video.
Dear healthcare professionals, welcome to Healthcare Engineering. I am Sumita, a biomedical engineer from Healthcare Engineering team. We are back with amazing presentations. We are going to share our knowledge and experiences, what we gain from the industry. I strongly believe that all kind of healthcare professionals and students can learn a lot from our YouTube channel and blog by knowing the modern trends in healthcare world. Therefore, I would like to welcome you all to subscribe our YouTube channel and press the bell icon to get instant updates of a new informative video. Also, you can visit our blog www.learnbiomedengine.blogspot.com to learn more on the concepts we share in our videos. We can support you in your healthcare business. We can advertise your healthcare products. We can promote your healthcare events. We can provide technical support for your medical devices and other online supports. If you are interested to get support from us, please contact our admin to the given mail ID. Our healthcare team is also active in social media platforms, Telegram, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn, WhatsApp, and Instagram. You can follow us in these social media groups and the link will be given in the description below. Today's video is about electrosurgical unit. What is electrosurgery? Electrosurgery is a procedure involved in cutting and coagulation of biological tissue. This procedure uses high frequency alternating electrical current. This is also used for dissection, fulguration, and for shrinking tissues. Electrosurgery is widely used in most of the departments involving tissue surgeries such as neuro, gynecology, dermatology, dental procedures, ENT, etc. Principles of electrosurgery. The main principle of electrosurgery is that it uses an alternating electric current at high frequency or radio frequency. The frequency ranges from 100 kHz to 5 MHz. This current is passed through the patient's body and produces the heat. Therefore, the surgical procedure is performed using an electrode and it is controlled either by hand switch or foot switch. We have two types of electrosurgery, monopolar versus bipolar. In monopolar electrosurgery, it consists of an electrosurgical generator, active electrode, patient and patient return electrode. During an operation, the patient's plate is attached to any part of the patient's body. Electric current is generated from the electrosurgery generator and it passes through the active electrode where it creates heat in the tissue as well as the entire body cavity and it returns back to the generator through patient return electrode. molar is the most commonly used method in electrosurgery. In bipolar electrosurgery, biforceps electrode is used. The forceps perform both the active and return electrode function. Forceps is used for grabbing the tissue and the electric current passes through the forceps to the respective area in the tissue. Therefore, this prevents further damage to other body parts and prevent the patient from any burns. Bipolar surgery uses only less voltage and hence it is not used for cutting and coagulation of larger bleeding tissues. Bipolar surgery is recommended in patients with implanted devices to prevent them from short circuit. Let's now move on to electrosurgical unit. Electrosurgical unit is a device used in electrosurgery for cutting, coagulation, fulguration and desiccation of tissues. Electrosurgical unit is used in surgeries to prevent blood loss. Electrosurgical unit consists of an electrosurgical generator with one or more electrodes and a patient return electrode. This unit is controlled using a hand switch or a foot switch. Electrosurgical unit creates electric current to pass through the electrode and produces heat in the tissue for cutting, coagulating and removing damaged tissues. It is operated under two modes, monopolar and bipolar. In monopolar mode, it consists of an active electrode and a patient return electrode. Active electrode is placed directly in the surgical area, which carries electric current to the tissue, whereas patient return electrode is placed in any part of the patient's body and it is used for taking back the current from the tissue. Bipolar mode. Bipolar mode is operated between patient and electrosurgical forceps. The forceps perform both active and return operations. As we have seen earlier, electric current is passed and received back through the forceps. What are the types of electrodes? They are needle electrode, wire loop electrode, angular electrode, blade electrode, and electrosurgical forceps. Wire loop electrode is used for cutting. Now we will see block diagram of electrosurgical unit in detail. Waveform generator. Waveform generator is used for producing heat. Therefore, high frequency power is required for heat generation. Different waveforms like cutting, coagulation and blending are also produced from this waveform generator. Mode selector. Mode selector is used for selecting type of modes that should be used while performing the surgery. Power level control determines the power applied to the electrodes during surgery. We also have an alarm circuit which is used for creating safety alarms. It checks whether the electrodes are properly attached in the patient circuit. We have a power amplifier which is used in the process of amplification. Therefore, monopolar output and the bipolar output is produced in the electrosurgical unit. What are the components of electrosurgical unit? It has front panel and rear panel. Now we will look into the front panel. It consists of a power on-off switch, mode selector and fault indicator switch. The power on-off switch is used for turning on of the electrosurgical unit. Mode selector is used for selecting the modes such as cut mode, coagulation mode and blend mode. Cut mode indicates yellow color whereas coagulation mode indicates blue color. Fault indicator switch is used for indicating poor contact of patient return electrode with the patient by producing alarm. This has both 3-pin and 2-pin connectors. Rear panel. Rear panel consists of foot switch control, volume control knob and power cord connection. Foot switch control is used for connecting the foot switch. Volume control knob is used for controlling the audio volume during cutting, coagulating or blending. And it also has a power cord connection. Preventive maintenance. regular testing of the equipment should be done. Person handling the equipment must be well trained by the manufacturer. He or she must follow the instructions given in the manual. Inspect the insulation wires properly. Low power setting must be used while starting. Safety precautions we must follow while handling the electrosurgical unit. Surgery must be performed by specially trained technicians. Electrosurgery should not be done in oxygen-rich environment. Before operating, insulation of the electrode must be checked carefully. Do not activate the equipment in open circuit. Do's and don'ts in an electrosurgical unit. Electrodes should be placed in clean, dry areas. Use only insulated electrodes. Electrode tips must be cleaned properly. Use only low voltage waveforms while operating. Now, what are the don'ts? One should not use the electrode in the presence of flame. Electrodes should not be wrapped around metal instruments. Rubber catheters should not be used in electrode tips. Do not operate the ESU in wet surface or by using wet hand or gloves. Do not use the equipment in patients prior to testing. Now, let's move on to the electrical safety and patient safety. Electrical safety. Proper power cord must be used. Use only fuses which have correct voltage and current rating. Patient safety. Proper contact must be maintained between the patient and other metal parts. Patient electrode must be connected in order to avoid skin injury. Ensure the connections made does not affect the blood supply in the patient. How to troubleshoot an electrosurgical unit. Check electrosurgical unit for any physical damage. Ensure all cables, electrodes, power cord are connected properly. Check the power cord properly or immediately replace it. Pin connections and switches must be properly checked. If any damage is found, it must be replaced immediately. Clinical applications of electrosurgery. Electrosurgery and electrosurgical unit is used in ENT to control nose bleeding, gynecology, ophthalmic surgery, dermatology to remove abnormal skin growth, moles, etc., and in removing lesions, hair follicles. It is also used in surgeries involving removal of body parts, tissues. If you want to learn more about electrosurgical unit, kindly visit our blog www.learnbiomedengine.blogspot.com. To promote your healthcare business, please contact us in the given mail ID. If you like to receive updates of a new video, please subscribe our YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. Also, please do comment your favorite topic or medical devices you are willing to learn. You can also follow us in the social media platforms. The link for joining is given in the description below. Thank you for watching.